CC Radio from the Sea Crane Company. Easier, cheaper, stupid mode. Bad, 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 bad. Cheap and bad. That's got to be kind of like the ultimate compliment.
If you were a listener to Art Bell's Coast to Coast AM show, you may remember hearing the ads for the CC Radio from Sea Crane. There have been several different generations of this radio over the years. There was the original CC Radio, and then in 2001 they introduced the CC Radio Plus, which is what I have here, which has the same basic functionality as the original, but adds some extra features and frills, which I'll go over. And then in 2009, they introduced the CC Radio 2, which replaced the TV audio reception with 2-meter amateur radio band reception, because analog TV was being phased out at that time. And then finally in 2013, they introduced the CC Radio 2E with enhanced audio performance, especially on AM. Because all the previous models, including this one, have a very narrow bandwidth on AM. Sea Crane calls it tuned for the human voice because it's not really good for listening to music on AM. But from what I've heard, the current CC Radio 2E model is much better on AM and has a much wider bandwidth. But at $169, the CC Radio 2E is rather pricey, so I was quite happy to find this one at the local thrift store for only $6. So this is the CC Radio Plus from sometime in the early to mid-2000s. It has FM, AM, analog VHF TV audio, and NOAA weather band reception. It has separate bass and treble controls. On the top it has 5 presets per band. The antenna folds all the way in. Although it's not very long, I was kind of surprised that it's not quite as long as I've expected from other radios of this kind. Although most of those other radios have shortwave, which would require a longer antenna than FM. So this is just for FM and weather band, so it doesn't need to be as long as if it had shortwave reception. When I first found this radio, the antenna was just sticking out like that, which I thought was rather odd. It seemed to stick out at a strange angle and not have any obvious way to fold it in, until I realized you just position it vertically and then it can fold all the way into the cabinet. So on the front it has a single 5-inch speaker and the digital readout for the clock and tuning display with a light, although it's not very bright. You can see it just has a single LED on each side. I believe the current model has increased that to 3 LEDs to make it light up brighter, but it's still good enough to read it in the dark when you turn it on. And if you have this plugged into AC power, it'll stay on all the time, or if you're running on batteries, it'll stay on for 2 minutes after the last time you've touched any of the controls, and then it'll shut off. On the front you have push button tuning, as well as a tuning dial on the side. On AM, this will tune in 10 kHz steps using the buttons, or 1 kHz steps using the dial. It has a lock switch to prevent you from accidentally hitting any of the controls, a volume dial, and a headphone output, which is stereo on FM. Although I've noticed there is no way to switch it into mono mode, which can be annoying when listening to weaker FM signals through the headphones. You'll hear that background hiss, and you won't be able to switch it into mono to cancel out that noise. On the back, it has a carrying handle. On this side, it has an aux input for connecting line-level audio sources, playing it through the built-in speaker. This is a remote output that switches on an external device when the radio turns on, because this has a timer, so you can time it to turn on at a certain time. And then Sea Crane sold a cassette recorder that went along with this, and if you connected this, it would also switch on the cassette recorder and start it recording. That was a special cassette recorder that could record up to 4 hours per side of tape. It was called the VersaCorder. Of course, these days they've replaced it with a digital audio recorder. And here's a line output, which is in stereo on FM. Here's your ground and external AM antenna input. For FM, you only get the rod antenna. There's no external FM antenna jack. Here's the battery compartment. It can run on 4D batteries or 120 volts AC. Here's some jacks that have been removed from the current version. It has a DC output for connecting it to an LED light. Back when they made the CCRadio Plus, LED lights were a new thing, so C-Crane sold a light that you can plug into this and have LED illumination powered by the radio's batteries. But these days you can get LED lights anywhere, so they've removed this feature, as well as the 6-volt DC charging input for connecting to a solar panel for charging the batteries if you use NiCad or nickel metal hydride batteries. I do not believe it charges the batteries if you use the regular AC input. And on the bottom you can see it's made in China. This was actually made by Sanjian, who manufactures all of C-Crane's radios for them. And you can find these branded as Sanjian as well as C-Crane. Although this one doesn't say either of them, it just says CC Radio Plus. And this radio is bigger than I expected. For size comparison, here is a VHF's tape. So it's quite a large portable radio, and it's quite heavy too, especially if the battery is installed. So it's not something you can easily hold into your hands while using it. You really need to set it down on a table to use it comfortably. So let's turn it on. A local Indian music station on AM. One thing I've noticed with this model is that the highest I can never get the tuning meter to go up to on AM is 3, whereas on FM it can go all the way up to 7. Although I notice if I put my finger on the external AM antenna terminal, it goes up quite a bit. So you can see the improvement in reception you can get by using the external antenna on AM. You can hear it doesn't have a very wide bandwidth on AM, but you can improve the audio on local stations by off-tuning by a couple of kilohertz. So you can go up to 3 kHz away from the center channel frequency and still have good reception. And tuning away from the frequency is also useful for reducing interference from neighboring stations, because I have a strong local station on 1170. So if I want to go to 1180, I can hear some of the splatter from that neighboring station. But if I go up to 1182, here the splatter is basically gone, and I'm hearing some kind of station playing Janis Joplin. And if you use the tuning dial on the side, you can hear it does not mute the audio as you're changing frequencies, so you can hear what's going on as you're tuning past the stations.
It's opinion, but has its own Richter scale. And I see the needles are about to move again as we go back to Levin.
810 and 1031, WGY.
But if you use the push button tuning, it mutes the audio momentarily as you're changing frequencies.
Liquid 325 degrees below zero cold. Connect Rizana Saeed at Acre Mortgage 267-270-1551 for all your mortgage and refinance needs.
So on AM, the frequency range is not really wide enough to notice that much of a difference with adjusting these controls, but definitely on FM you can hear the difference. So I'll switch over to FM here.
Property, tax appeals, and property management. More information available at 1-800-541-1999 or by email at rwamerica@aol.com. WOLD New Jersey
weather. Partly cloudy skies tonight, an early shower or thunderstorm with a low in the mid-70s. Stays warm and humid. More the same.
And you can see it shows the stereo indicator on FM even if you don't have headphones plugged in. And on FM, the tuning dial tunes in 50 kilohertz steps, which makes it quite a long way to get across the band by using the dial. But it goes a little bit faster if you use the buttons. Those tune in 100 kilohertz steps. And it does have good audio quality on FM, but it's not as good through the speaker as a GE Super Radio. But it can get quite loud. And it's quite selective on FM. I'm at the low end of the band where there are a bunch of stations crowded together on adjacent channels, and it can pick up all of them easily.
Okay. On all of them, based in Brooklyn.
I'm aware of most of the time I work.
Buttons pressed, you will produce certain.
So it has very good reception on FM. The analog TV reception isn't of much use anymore, but definitely the weather radio is.
Partly cloudy with a slight chance of showers and thunderstorms this evening. Then.
I can pick up three or four different stations.
At the Long Beach Island weather flow, the air temperature was 81 degrees. The winds were from the south at 8 knots.
Some of them are using this new voice, which sounds a lot better than the old synthesized voices that NOAA weather radio used.
At the Kite Island weather flow, the air temperature was 81 degrees. The winds were from the south at 9 knots. At the Brick weather flow, the air temperature was 79 degrees.
So I'll leave you with some direct hookup samples of AM and FM reception on the CC Radio Plus as recorded through its line level output.
And now here is your host for the evening, Don Ameche. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and good evening. Francis, before you get away, I want to tell you that I thought your song was delightful. And Toby, your commercial was stimulating. And Carmen, your music was magnificent.
Boy, you feel great tonight, don't you?
Yeah, I certainly do, Carmen.
Radio. Carly Simon on the 80s at 8, coming around again from a movie called Heartburn, and from her album as well. She did an album and had on it songs like Itsy Bitsy Spider. I don't think I've ever heard that one by her, but maybe I'll give it a whirl. Give Me All Night was her follow-up, and that did pretty well too. Coming Around Again was the biggest single from that album.
Import, new or used, manual or automatic, cherry red or fire engine red. We answer all the tough questions on the Omdic Auto Show on AM 900 CHML. Mohamed Hushama, Executive Director of Car Help Canada, doles out his experience on the auto industry and helps you with car advice. And unlike your mechanic, it's absolutely free. The Omdic Auto Show, current Saturdays from noon to 1 on Hamilton's News Talk Leader, AM 900 CHML.
Another adventure of Casey, crime photographer, ace cameraman who covers the crime news of a great city. Written by Alonzo Dean Cole, our adventure for tonight, Pickup. 9 o'clock in the evening, the Blue Note Cafe. Ethelbert, the head bartender, is chatting with a customer, a tall, thin, white-haired man with a gentle face, when he hears a familiar voice.
You are listening to Noah's El Hazard Radio, station KWO 35 in New York City. This broadcast originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office located on the grounds of Brookhaven National Laboratory in Upton, New York. Station KWO 35 broadcasts on a frequency of 162.55 MHz.
The offshore waters forecast for Hudson Canyon to Baltimore Canyon, out to 1,000 fathoms. Tonight, variable winds less than 10 knots, becoming south to southwest. Seas 2 to 3 feet. Tuesday, south winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 20 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet.
...avec notamment le traditionnel tintamarre. Il défile dans les rues en faisant du bruit pour montrer la vitalité de l'Acadie. Des festivités ont lieu dans les quatre coins des provinces de l'Atlantique et ailleurs. Le Premier ministre Justin Trudeau participe aux festivités à Caraquet, au Nouveau-Brunswick, en compagnie de la ministre du patrimoine canadien Mélanie Joly et du Premier ministre du Nouveau-Brunswick, Brian Gallant. Voilà ce qui conclut votre bulletin d'information. Pour plus de détails, rendez-vous sur ici.radio-canada.ca. Vous écoutez Ici Radio-Canada, première.
Veuillez noter que l'émission qui suit vous est présentée en rappel.
Bonjour à tous et à toutes. Comment allez-vous? Isabelle Craig avec vous pour ces deux heures de Medium Large et pour la dernière semaine. Et oui, c'est déjà un peu la rentrée pour certains et pour les autres, que voulez-vous? C'est les vacances. Hein? Faut bien qu'il y ait une justice en ce monde.
The Voice of St. Louis. News Radio 1120 KMOX. KMOX HD St. Louis. 102.5 KEZK HD3 St. Louis.
CBS News, I'm Bill Whitney.